This is a production of PBS 39.
Well, college life might not be for everyone, but for one young man in Easton, it's a natural fit. You might say he was born to go to college. In fact, he feels right at home on the quad, in the lecture halls, and most especially in the president's house. For Teddy Weiss, Lafayette College is more than a place to learn. It's a place to grow up. Grover Silcox has his story.
Some kids have a tough time adjusting to college. This kid, however, not only made the adjustment, but actually thrives on college life.
I like how everywhere I ride, anybody I see, like if I'm just going over to my dad's office, everybody there will say, "Oh, what's up, Teddy? How's it going?"
Speed demon, keep it under 90.
How are you doing?
Pretty good.
Teddy Weiss, age 10, loves life at Lafayette College. Even though he's not a student there, he didn't matriculate. He just moved in with his dad, college president Dan Weiss, his mom, Sandra, and little brother, Joel. The family Weiss settled into the historic president's house in 2005, and from day one, Teddy served as the school's unofficial ambassador of goodwill.
Hey, Ned.
Teddy is very outgoing. If ever there was a child born to be part of a college community, it's Teddy. He arguably knows everyone on campus.
You know, we have the ball up here, we hold it in place, and we step and we throw.
Everyone includes Lafayette football coach Frank Tavani, who loves to give Teddy a few good pointers.
As you can see, when we're throwing the ball around, he's got the basic techniques down. As with everything with Teddy, he's on top of it.
As far as coaches go, Frank's tops with Teddy. He even gave the coach a special award a couple years back.
He presented me with a very nice gift of appreciation for a championship season, so it's something that I cherish.
Teddy just marvels at the myriad of people who make up his small-town college community, and they respond to his unfettered spirit.
It's very infectious, and so lots of the adults that he works with or interacts with, you know, feel that, and they really like to have him around.
Hey, Teddy, what's up, buddy?
Dave Kovach, groundskeeper for the president's house, tends the gardens and works on special projects, such as the new patio in front of Lafayette's Colton Chapel.
Dave is the groundskeeper here, and he's pretty much one of my best friends. I help him out around the house with weeding and trimming.
Teddy, he's always a great help. He's very enthusiastic on everything that I do. He wants to be there with me. So if it comes to digging holes or pulling weeds, Teddy always wants to be there doing it.
That's Teddy, always eyeing the next project. Why, he devoured the history of the president's house from housekeeper Dana McFadden, who gives visitors guided tours.
He knows all the information. I mean, he's got a mind, like, you know, everything sticks once he hears it.
Now Teddy gives tours of his own for new students, visiting dignitaries, and even curious reporters.
William Cassidy Cattell, the sixth president of Lafayette College, had purchased it for his daughter.
Teddy got to thinking a video about the house might enhance the tour, so he struck up a partnership with Dana to work on it. It is currently a work in progress. He even called the college archivist for advice about old photos. It might not come as a surprise that Teddy wants to be a film producer when he grows up.
If he wants to do it, he can do it. To be a good producer, it seems to me, you have to be an entrepreneur. You have to have a very powerful imagination. So if he sets his mind to it, it'll happen.
Lou Rita, president of Lou Rita Productions in Easton, knows what it takes to be a film producer. As a friend of the Weiss family and a keen observer of talent, Lou's already sized up Teddy's potential.
The first time I've run into a young man that's 10, 11 years old, that's got the ability, that's got the charisma, has the smarts, and I honestly feel that he really knows where he's going.
While Lou keeps an eye on Teddy's budding talent, Teddy looks for his next mission, like sharing something new with his dad's executive assistant, Maria Nia.
He is such a joy when that door bursts open and you can hear him before you see him. And he just comes in with a big smile on his face, full of energy and wanting to tell you about his day.
I was just on the computer and I found out how to make it talk to you.
Welcome to Lafayette College.
See?
It worked.
Teddy's a bright young man, but he's also a fun kid. And it's that combination that seems to bring out the very best in everyone around him, whether it's his mom and dad, younger brother Joel, Lafayette visitors, students, or staff. He's got that something special that makes folks feel, well, special.
Teddy with his Razor scooter, you know, you just never know where you're going to find him. And students love to see him. I've seen him at lectures. I've seen him at fun social events. I've seen him at fundraising events. I have seen Teddy at almost every kind of event.
That's Teddy all over. A guy on the move, not only college bound at age 10, but bound for success and a whole lot of fun. For Tempo, I'm Grover Silcox, reporting.